Hello 9th standard children, today I am going to study sociology. In that first chapter, family, the living together of husband and wife with children or without children for a long time is called as a family. Man has formed many social institutions to fulfill his basic needs. Among these institutions, family is the most important one, children. The word family is derived from the Latin word, and that is known as a famulus, which means to serve, children. Now we'll study about the characteristics of the family. By understanding the characteristics of the family, we can compare the importances of the family. First one, family is universal. Though it varies in accordance to the specific geographical nature and time period, the family is found in all societies only. Here what we'll see means, children, the families follow a fixed pattern in issues like marriages, nurturing, kinships and property things, children. And generally, the members who belong to the particular family resident in the same place or in the same room. Now, second point in a characters, it is the basic unit for all the social activities. Every activities of the social institution starts from the family only. In that, the political, economic, educational and survival other activities of society begin from the family only, children. Now, third one is a continuously responsibility and other accountability. It trains its children on how to live harmoniously with the neighbors. Along with this, it also educates about few social responsibilities. For example, it educates how to keep the drinking water source clean, children. Fourth one, bringing up the nurturing. The family creates the basic rights and the responsibilities and regard to the children. It is a duty of the family to take care of the elders during their old age. Okay, children. Fifth one, teaches social behavior. The family teaches the children about the ways of interacting with elders and the peer group. This means the social behavior era, the demands and the troubles indirectly control the children. The family teaches behavior like friendship, freedom and security during the childhood, adult and in the old age, children. In a sixth point, children, it instructs the traditionals. Like family includes several generations. It introduces the kinship. It outlines the relationship between the grandfather, mother, father, mother and the sibling. Now we'll study of the types of the family. Matriarchal family, and next one is a Prantachala family. In matriarchal family, the right of the property and the successorship belongs to the woman only. It means here the woman will be the head of the family, children. Okay. What means right of the property belongs to the woman only, and the hereditary rights pass on the daughter from the mother, children. So the authority, how she'll get her? From her mother only to the daughter. This step where we'll see means, children, it is near the coastal areas of the Karnataka. Matriarchal means here a mother centralized the families. Okay, children. In a Patanjali family, father is the head of the family, children. In a practical family, who is the head, children, here? It's again here. Father is the head here, children. In this family system, the eldest son has the prominent role in the religion ceremony. Okay, children. Now, again one family, modern nuclear family. Here, based on the structure and the generation live together, families are divided, are known as what? Nuclear family. Family that consists of father, mother and their unmarried children as a member is called as what? Nuclear family. So this is known as a nuclear family, children. First point you can get here, children, inclusivity, focus on the individual achievements, conspect of the individual happiness, change in the value system with regard to the right of the property. And in a fifth one, we'll get the rapid urbanizations, science and technology is their children, concept of the equality. Small in size is their children, nuclear family, simple social control, more freedom to the members, favors modern technology and complete sectorally. Now let's study about the joint family. A family consists of grandfather, grandmother, their children and their grandchildren and the grandchildren's, and in some situation the members belong to the extended to the two generation. That is known as what, children? A joint family. Okay. Now let's study about the characteristics of the joint family. First point, large in size. Members are more in the joint family because of it consists of the people of the two or more generation under the same roof. So it is in large in size. Second, coordinational, co-coordination and a cooperation. The members of the joint family cooperate in all activities of day-to-day life, children. The division of work is based on the age, difficulty level of the work, children. Through the eldest member supervise the family as the head only, children, and all the decision will be taken by the elders only to the members. Third point, residence and the kitchens. Members of joint family normally resident together under one same roof. Though the members residence separately for the variation reasons. Okay. Members eat the food prepared in the same kitchen only. Okay. Then religion. Members of joint family believe in the same religion and practice their worship, and religion belief are common in the nature. Self-sufficient unit. Here, joint family is a self-sufficient unit. It satisfies all the needs of the family members. Structures of authority. The senior members of the joint family are entrusted with the authority and responsibility. The handing over the authority is based on the seniority in the family. So whatever the authority is there, it will be given the work by the seniors only in the family, children. With this, I have completed the lesson. Thank you, children.